Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for your attendance at this Faculty of Science graduation ceremony. The official proceedings will begin shortly, and in a moment the graduands will enter the auditorium and I shall invite you to stand. They will be followed by the academic procession and then the official party. As the official party enters, we invite you to join the singing of the traditional graduation song, Gaudeamus. Please then take your seats as the Chancellor takes his seat. If you're carrying a cell phone, please ensure it's either turned off now or made silent. And whilst you're welcome to take photos, please move back to your seat immediately after having taken them, and please do not stand in the aisles. At the end of the ceremony, the Chancellor will invite the gathering to sing God Defend New Zealand. Please then remain standing following the end of the anthem as the processions leave the auditorium. And once the last graduates have left, you will also be invited to leave. Would you now please all stand?
Please be seated.
Ina mana, ina reo, ina hui fa, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Vice Chancellor, Pro Chancellor, Council members, members of the University, special guests, graduands, families and friends. I extend a warm welcome to this, the fourth spring graduation ceremony for 2011 of the University of Auckland. This week, the University is bestowing a total of 2,708 qualifications on some 2,450 students. At this ceremony, degrees will be conferred and diplomas awarded in the Faculty of Science, a total of 430 in person, plus a further 169 in absentia. I am privileged as Chancellor to preside at spring graduation for a third year. The regularity of graduation ceremonies makes them no less special for the University and me personally than for those of you being capped here today, many for the first time. It is also a pleasure to return to the Auckland Town Hall, long our traditional graduation venue, for the first time since 2009. The Aotea Centre, which we now use, has been temporarily captured for Rugby World Cup purposes. Graduation is a festive event rich in history, pomp and colour with a lively array of contemporary touches. Here in Auckland, our rich mix of cultures and ethnicities can be seen in the striking variety of dress and adornments worn by graduands. Today is one of hard-earned celebration by you, the graduands and diplomates, on your academic accomplishments, and by your family and friends who have encouraged and supported you and are here to share in your success. The University, represented by the Council and academic staff members seated behind me, and those many staff who control proceedings with remarkable precision, takes equal pleasure at this hugely significant day for each and every one of you. The University of Auckland is deservedly ranked as one of the best universities in the world. Your qualifications will always serve you well in this country and abroad, whether in qualifying you for a satisfying career or in leading to more advanced study, or simply as a route to personal and intellectual enrichment. In today's ever-changing workforce, you cannot afford to stop learning. So please keep in mind our enormous range of postgraduate opportunities. I urge you, as alumni of New Zealand's leading university, always to remember your alma mater. We depend increasingly on our graduates for support, moral and political, as well as financial. Your advocacy and influence are vital in encouraging government and the community at large to fund universities so they can generate the knowledge needed to drive a productive and competitive economy and to create a full and satisfying life for all New Zealanders. At the same time, philanthropy has become critically important to our university, funding major capital projects, scholarships and professorial chairs. The crucial contribution of major research universities is not well understood and therefore insufficiently acknowledged. It is inconceivable that a developed, progressive 21st century nation can maintain that status without strong, internationally recognised research-based universities, such as the University of Auckland. Our innovative research is vital for long-term sustainable economic growth and social cohesion, never more so than in the testing times we face in the wake of the global recession and the devastating Christchurch earthquakes. Universities equip graduates like you not simply for the jobs of today, but for future careers not yet imagined. Universities need greater investment by government, the commercial sector, and private philanthropy, not less. But that's sufficient for me on the challenges facing our institution. For today is unquestionably your day. I congratulate you and trust that you will long cherish memories of your graduation in September 2011. We welcome as our speaker this morning Professor John Montgomery, who holds the Chair of Marine Science at this University of Auckland. He is the director of our Lee Marine Laboratory, which is effectively our marine campus, with state-of-the-art teaching and research facilities and an impressive new interpretive centre for visitors. He is also on the board of Antarctica New Zealand. Professor Montgomery gained a BSc Honours degree at the University of Otago and both a PhD and a Doctor of Science from the University of Bristol. His scientific work sits at the interface of marine science and neuroscience. He has published extensively on the sensory behaviour and physiology of fish, including hearing, flow sensors, and the novel electrosensory system of sharks and rays. His work has been recognised by election to the Royal Society of New Zealand, an International Brain Research Organisation Fellowship, and a Fulbright Scholarship. He is also active in promoting marine science and communicating science to the public. Professor Montgomery.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, University colleagues, graduands, parents, family and friends, it's a great privilege to be invited to give this graduate address to you and to share the celebration. A ceremony such as this is a public tribute to the good decisions made, the hard work done and the support provided by families, friends and teachers. And it's such a treat to see all the support here, the cultural diversity and the depth of talent of you, the graduands. Your moment is shortly to come when you'll cross the stage here and receive your degree, and we are here to celebrate that moment. One way I like to think about a moment like this is it's a bit like an hourglass, or given the allotted time, perhaps more like an old-fashioned egg timer. I don't know whether you know the ones I mean or not, but there's an hourglass shape made of glass with sand in it, and that when you turn it upside down, the sand flows through that narrow neck of the glass and marks the passage of time. So when the sand has run out, the hour or the time has come to take the egg off the boil. Today's graduation is like an hourglass in that all the choices and hard work of the past flow through a point in time and open up the potential of the future. Some of these moments, like the ceremony today, are surrounded by tradition and illuminated by the stage lights. These moments are easy to see and important to treasure. But I'd also like to, in this address, shine the spotlight on other less obvious, less public moments that are no less important in the path that has led you to the completion of your degree. There will have been moments, and I'm sure that all of you can bring them to mind, that were less well signposted, but equally important. Inspiration from a particular teacher, a specific commitment of support from your family, or a friend who's laid down a challenge which has led you down this path and to the ceremony today. I can certainly remember critical path choices in my own pre-degree days as a last year high school student having a chat on Castor Bay Beach with Professor John Morton, who in effect then held the position that I now hold at the university. The upshot of that meeting was a clear choice to study biology at the university, despite not having done so at school. Then again, as a second year student attending a lunchtime lecture by visiting Professor Eric Denton, who was the director of the Lee Marine Laboratory at Plymouth. And through subsequent contact with Professor Denton, he became my PhD advisor. And this in turn led to a lifetime's interest and work in the crossover area between neuroscience and marine science, as you heard in the introduction. Now, let me just drill into that a little bit. Neuroscience and marine science may sound like an odd mix, but marine animals have formed important models for the study of the nervous system and for fundamental neuroscience. To give you just two examples, at the Plymouth Lab, about 20 years before I arrived there to do my PhD, the discovery had been made of how nerves conduct action potentials and hence transmit information from one part of the brain to another or from the nervous system out to the muscles. This work was actually done on squid by two researchers whose names were Hodgkin and Huxley, and in neuroscience, they're very well known for that contribution. Perhaps a little less known, but interesting in terms of the theme that I want to pursue today, is that they shared their Nobel Prize with John Eccles, who, although an Australian, did this part of the work for the Nobel Prize that he shared with them here in New Zealand. In addition to that, he was responsible for setting up New Zealand's first marine laboratory because he was well aware and understood the importance of marine animals as models for neuroscience. If you need further convincing, there's just one other example of the way in which marine science and neuroscience intersect. The second example is more recent. A scientist called Eric Kandel, again working at a marine lab, was awarded the Nobel Prize in 2002 for discovering the cellular basis of learning. He did this work on a marine slug, not unlike the ones that have been washing up on our beaches the last couple of summers and poisoning the dogs. Understanding the basis of how nerves work and how learning occurs in the nervous system are fundamental discoveries. In science, these discoveries are again like passing through the hourglass, a point in time, a particular discovery that opens up a wealth of future potential. I've specifically mentioned Kandel's work because, amongst other things, it has given us real insight into how we see and remember these important moments in our lives. It's all about neuromodulation, and it works pretty much the same in sea slugs as it does in us. There's a bit of the brain called the amygdala that sits next to the area where memories are laid down. What this bit of the brain does is recognize the significance of what's happening around us. If the amygdala fires up, it sends out the neuromodulation signal to the adjacent brain area, and you'll lay down a strong memory of that particular occasion. You don't have to know this to appreciate the significance of your ceremony today, but knowing it may help you recognize and see these moments of opportunity in the future. Some will be well signposted, others may not, but you can coach your mind's eye to see these special moments of opportunity. These are the moments that will open up the potential of your future. It's up to you to see the moment. So let me finish by again extending my congratulations to you all. We celebrate your achievements and your moment at this ceremony today. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Montgomery, for a very interesting speech and reminding our graduates in particular that they are laying down strong memories today and no doubt seizing the moment. This is a meeting of council and convocation of the university for a ceremony of conferring degrees and awarding of diplomas. At this ceremony, the Pro-Chancellor, Ian Parton, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I now invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of this ceremony.
Thank you, Chancellor. By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Pro-Chancellor, confer the degrees and award the diplomas stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Science, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon an Associate Dean of the Faculty of Science, Dr. Brennan, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Associate Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the conferment of a degree for the award of a diploma in the Faculty of Science. Graduate Diploma in Science, Eric Luor. Min Wang. To the degree of Bachelor of Optometry, Fan Wu. To the degree of Bachelor of Technology with Second Class Honours, First Division, Ing Keet Tan. To the degree of Bachelor of Technology with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Kuan Yu Lin. To the degree of Bachelor of Science, Sabri Farouk Abdallah. Huda Abdul Aziz. Nurfa Fiza Abdul Karim. Shakira Ahmad Mahir. Dua Haytham Akil. Vicky Louise Alderson Wallace. Natasha Nazia Ali. Rachel Dominica Olympia Almeida. Zaid Saad Sukrat Amso. Samuel George Anderson. Phoebe Rose Armitage. Lila Amira Isis. Hakim Bayman. Madeline Grace Barbridge. Harry Benjamin James Barnes. Elisa Hope Berimbali. Shivani Biku Ragabula. Tanya Bota. Lara Ann Bryan. Melissa Cadellis. Ashley Claire Carden. Michael James Carswell. Zin Lee Chai. Timothy Zong In Chen. Wai Chi Eddie Chen. Chanel Smittle Chandra. Chia Chun Chang. Siu Han Chan. Kai Jay Chang. Chi Wu Chung. Tin Chi Chow. Che Yong Chung. Ashley Taylor Clark. Nikki Jade Clendinning. Victoria Morella Cockle, Charlotte Joy Connell, Catherine Michelle Coop, Danielle Patricia Courtney, Samantha Gail Krevagen, Stephen James Dolby, Samuel Kieran Davis, Anastasia Emanuela DeVoe, Rebecca Faith Dieudonné, Blaise Ryan Dowis, Brennan Roshanth Duro Nayagam, Abigail Boncalis Esnaola, Philippa Ellie Farmer, Cameron Fasami, Jan Marquio Velasco Feliciano, Carl Robert Flashinsky, Daniel Servas Paul Frings, Nicholas James Gallagher, Jonathan James G, Nicholas Junji Go, Samantha Lee Goff, Benny Gao Zhuan Hui, Anton Kim Gully, Georgia Faye Guy Williams, Samia Hakimi, Lin Han, Suzila Hanafi, Zubaida Hari, Joshua Sinclair Harlan, Ian Frederick Havel, Shannon Miles Hecker, Alana Victoria Hendel, Elisa Courtney Hildred, Rudolin Joyce M. Hippolito, Lauren Janine Hockey, Roderick John Holland, Sumbiom Hong, Claire Louise Honey, Paul Richard Horniman, Gregory Bruce Housel, P. Hei Huan Shui. Yu Hui. Kieran Mark Highland. Moaz Ali Muhammad Ibrahim. Ismas Ismail. Nabila Binti Ismail. Nurul Atika Izaha. Jae Yong Jang. Jin Hyuk Jang. Hyun Woo Jun. Yoon Ki Yong Jung. Minao Kalyan. Alex Soo Hyung Kim. Yong Hyun Kim. Ziad Tia Kyriakos. Kao Wing Catherine Koo. Anshu Avantika Kumar. Ting Ting Kai. Yung Gung Kong. Nichols Chin Ho Lao. Bernie Paul Larson. Ong Kyo Min Lat. Megan Suagal Rose Lavelle. Jonas Erico Bueno Lazaro. Jiyun Lee. Lockie Leung. Chi Lee. Yun Chuan Lee. Ashley Sydney Lilly. Hee Sun Lim. Anthony Wei Jian Lu. Chen Liu. Ying Liu. Julie Ann Livingston. Samuel William Cookson Loader. Hannah Margaret Lau. Christopher Stephen Lowther. Lisa Liu. Richard Yu Tran Liu. Sonia Liu. Ki Hao Long. Mafusa Mansour. Kalakiko Mataele. Tarai Lillian Vakili Mataitini. Matthew David McAdams. Robert William Mickenman. Nicole Sarah Mackay. Shane Grant McNeil. Daniel Hamish Mee. Hitamalaja Talini Wasama Kumari Migola. Shintan Ashok Mehta. Hamish Richard Melville. Rohan Rajendra Menon. Adam Chadwick Miller. Nur Diana Muhammad Pakarul Razi. Fatima Maryam Bahar Muhammad Bahar. Ziti Fahama Muhammad Lassim. Tasina Mone. Kirsten A. Montgomery. Nur Hafiza Binti Musa. Ashlyn Nand. Nalini Navarajan. Samuel Ng. Andre Nikovic. Zachary Maritina Honora. Yuko Pacey. Adrian Palwanka. Jihe Park. Kylie Marie Elizabeth Parks. Anthony Chantelal Patel. William Henry Patterson. Priya Pawar. Holly Alexandra Poole. Anne Michelle Poolgreen. Natasha Neelam Prasad. Dan Olaf Fane Tahuhu Rua Rokarere Rasmussen. Harish Chattaravel Ratna Sabat Tapati. Jordan Leanne Rouse. Maryam Ruslam. Emma Margaret Sheltama. Catherine Christie Schmidt. Sadavani Shripti Sen. Young Kyung So. Indra Seti Awan. Nurul Hisna Binti Shaberi. Sahan Shafia. Firdaus Banu Zakir Ahmed Sheikh. Jiaxing Shao. Sumit Shivad. Junho Shin. Yunyong Shin. Stephen Ming Hong Xu. Eileen Sher. Karen C.R. Elin. Ching Yi Sim. Peter Joseph Simpson. Richard Bruce Simpson. Nivjot Singh Situ. Norleen Datesha Siral. Charlene Elise Smith. Suk Ki Song. Junru Song. Hayley Christine Sparks, Senior Scholar in Geography. Christina Spesovsky. Adam Paul Speakman. Brittany Sarah Stevens. Catherine Jean Strawn. Jerusian Manohar Subramaniam. Sun Lei. Sisi Sun. Ankana Subanachit. Weili Tan. Danika Min Tong. Xiaowen Tang. Ji Tang. Hulito Fieloaki Ofahilodu Taveli. Jessica Allison Taylor. Kieran Neville John Teron. Jaspreet Tind. Marika Elizabeth Julia Thomas. Abby Jean Thompson. Laura Megan Tippett. Sean Kwaitung Sung. Ken Ying Tu. Evelinga Elaine Likavai Dubow. A Amy Petra title. Paul Edmund Tynan. Jennifer Van Der Lee. Jacques Van Der Merwe. Victoria Van. Rumia Velalagan. Abhishek Verma. Lakshita Vijay.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of this ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Nick Hall, Laura Prendergast, and Patricia Robertson-Bickers on trumpet will now perform Fanfare for St. Edmundsbury by Benjamin Britten.
Thank you.
Well, of course, that's actually quite a recent piece of music. I think it first played only 50 years ago, but it's entirely appropriate that we would have a trumpet fanfare for graduation, and it was beautifully played by Nick and Laura and Patricia. Can I ask you to show your appreciation again, please? By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Roger France, Chancellor, confer the degrees and award the diplomas stated upon those who within their faculty have satisfied the requirements of this university. I now call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Science, Professor Guildford, to present further graduands in that faculty.
Meliami Vulangi. Wan Aida Sarana Wan Ramlan. Jachi Wang. Iran Wang. Vanessa Elizabeth Ward. Jonathan Michael Watts Henwood. Philip Yat Ming Wong. Mo Wu. Vesa Zara. Ming Ying Chu. Feng Yang. Hoi Yang Yong. Annabelle Rifong Yong. Hyun Woo Yu. Patrick Park Lip Yu. Tara Zaya. Yi Zing. Sheng Zing. Ju Chong. Lei Xiong. Yibin Chang. Xing Ji. Chong Jing. Xin Zhong. Uglesa Zorich. To the degree of Bachelor of Science Conjoint, Peter William Akers and a Bachelor of Arts. Peter was also a senior scholar in German. Samantha Odessa Almeida and a Bachelor of Commerce. Matthew Bernard Carlson and a Bachelor of Arts. Yong Ho Cho and a Bachelor of Arts. Madeline Ann Clark and a Bachelor of Arts. Melissa Claire Dunn and a Bachelor of Commerce. Kirsten Rose Hall, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jessica Ruth Hendy, and a Bachelor of Arts. Naomi Coe, and a Bachelor of Arts. Emma Rachel Moffat, and a Bachelor of Arts. Calvin Paul Norton, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Reha Patel, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Samantha Wong, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Postgrad Diploma in Applied Psychology. Mathina Rashmi Mahawaru. Postgrad Diploma in Forensic Science. Stephanie Avon Lowry. Postgraduate Diploma in Science with Distinction. Michelle Renee Kangaroo in Biosecurity and Conservation. Raja Lashimi Chandran in Computer Science. Lloyd Joseph Franks in Environmental Management. Leonie Zandra Pipe in Biological Sciences. Su Rui Yang in Computer Science. Postgraduate Diploma in Science with Merit, Kyle Daniel De Rosario in Biomedical Science. Angela Joyce Peirinese Malupe Aua Doreen Ezini. Zanada Cantaline Heranti in Environmental Science. Maureen Gay O'Higgins in Environmental Science. Joseph Alexander Schanzer in Environmental Science. Cecilia Andrea Vidal Cruz in Environmental Science. Anna Teresa Starrett Wright in Marine Science. Jun Hyuk Young in Statistics. The Postgrad Diploma in Science, Sivagatai Aragapan in Food Science. Divya Ambavani in Food Science. Melanie Jane Berg in Medical Statistics and a Bachelor of Science. Rong Chen in Chemistry. Mukund Doshi in Biological Sciences. Kurt Lawrence Murray Drew in Chemistry. Ujita Uranga Galapathigay in Chemistry. Fiona Catherine Hart in Environmental Management. Saad Said Irfan Irfan in Biological Sciences. Jun Jiang in Statistics. Ihab Nihad Mahmoud Jurgis in Biological Sciences. Monita Sharon Annabelle Joshua in Food Science. Li Shi in Environmental Management. Aida Murat Begovic in Physics. Michael Ramos Noel in Environmental Science. Nicola Marie Parsons in Geography. Rohit Palouse in Food Science. Enmol Anand Prasad in Biosecurity and Conservation. Laola Afalisi Lee Schuster in Environmental Management. Jifang Shen in Statistics. Rajat Takar in Pharmacology. Bharath Singh Thakur in Environmental Science. Christina Zhang in Environmental Management. Chu Yang Zhang in Computer Science. Xiaoshi Sheng in Environmental Science. To the degree of Bachelor of Science Honours with First Class Honours. Lisa Susan Fendel, Susanna Fendel in Biological Sciences. And Lisa was also a University Graduate Scholar. Matthew Jonathan Gibson in Mathematics and a Bachelor of Science. Jin Takian in Medicinal Chemistry. To the degree of Bachelor of Science Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division, Velvet Nyung Kum Lee in Statistics. Leland John Oakey in Computer Science. To the degree of Bachelor of Science Honours with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Yi Lu in Bioinformatics. To the degree of Master of Speech Language Therapy Practice with Second Class Honours, First Division, Helen Elizabeth Andrew. To the degree of Master of Science with First Class Honours, Alistair Avery Abbott in Computer Science, University Graduate Scholar. Sylvia Charlotte Barnes in Health Psychology. Jennifer Jean Barrett in Biological Sciences. Shane Michael Bayliss in Biological Sciences. Rachel Hannah Boyle in Biomedical Science. Mira Brakovic in Chemistry. Richard Hugh Bulmer in Marine Science. Abby Sarah Dean in Geology and a postgrad diploma in Science with merit in Geology. Chihui Ding in Computer Science. Stacey Ann DeMello in Biomedical Science. Trishan Ashok Gajanand in Sport and Exercise Science. Amelia Perry Gamblin in Forensic Science. Valimir Sergeevich Yevsky in Biological Sciences. Also a postgrad diploma in science with distinction in wine science. Chanchu Gay in computer science. Emily Jane Gorman in health psychology. Dunisha Kumari Gunasekara in Biomedical Science, University Doctoral Scholar. Kate Elizabeth Hodgkins in Marine Science. Mirjana Glenda Orczyk in Chemistry and a Bachelor of Science. Wang Gwoon Jung in Biological Sciences. Yi Chun Lee in Food Science. Catherine Zhu Chen Lin in Mathematics. Sam Manuela in Psychology, University Graduate Scholar. Kimberly Nicole Maskell in Psychology. Stephanie Ann Miller in Psychology. Sophie Francis Malloy in Geology. Sophie also graduated with a postgrad diploma in science with merit in geology. Sarah Jane Moroney in food science and a postgrad diploma in science with distinction in food science. Sarah Margaret Ann Moss in biological sciences. Gabrielle Celeste Munro in psychology. Helen Waimaria Nathan in biosecurity. Helen also graduated with a postgraduate diploma in science with distinction in environmental science, and she was a university graduate scholar. James Sanford Nelson in mathematics. Joseph Richard Nelson in physics. Bachelor of Science in Honours with First Class Honours in Physics and a University Graduate Scholar. Shatharangi Manamikala Nalumdinaya in Psychology and a Bachelor of Science Honours with Second Class Honours First Division. Claire Elizabeth O'Donovan in Health Psychology. Songyi Park in Biomedical Science. Loida Palanka in Biological Sciences. Tertius Ralph in Applied Mathematics. Simon David Randall in Biosecurity and a Postgrad Diploma in Science with Merit in Biosecurity. Tania Cattell Rebleau in Computer Science. Ben Courtney Stevenson in Statistics and a Bachelor of Science Honours with First Class Honours in Statistics and a University Graduate Scholar. Ding Sun in Biomedical Science. Brendan Walter Swan in Biological Sciences. Amali Himashini Thrimawathi Nana in Bioinformatics. Atiku Raymond in Applied Mathematics. Matthew Philip Walbron in Physics. Chiong Kai in Statistics. Chiong also graduated with a Bachelor of Science Honours with First Class Honours in Statistics. Ying Chiong, Psychology, and a Postgrad Diploma in Science with Merit in Psychology. Xu Yu Xu in Chemistry. To the degree of Master of Science with second class honours, first division, Zakia Ahmad in Applied Mathematics. Stephanie Rihanna Benucci in Geography. Scott Douglas Carruthers in Geology. Simon Craig Connell in Biological Sciences. Prashanata Kuwongju in Biomedical Science. Prashanata also graduated with a postgraduate diploma in science with merit in biomedical science. Shenshin Mu in Computer Science and a Bachelor of Science Honours with second class honours, first division in Applied Mathematics and a Bachelor of Science. Tong Pang in Biomedical Science. Rachel Marcella Pindney in Geography. Kiri Petrie in Forensic Science. Blake Matthew Sears in Statistics. Emma Louise Turner in Geology. Emma also graduated with a postgraduate diploma in science with merit in geology. To the degree of Master of Science with second class honours, second division, Chang Yu Kim in Computer Science. Chang is also receiving a postgraduate diploma in science and computer science. Siu Ka Lee in Forensic Science. Mihail Pavlovich Legkodomov in Biological Sciences. Kai Luo Li in Statistics and a postgraduate diploma in Science and Statistics. Claire Lyons in Environmental Management and a postgraduate diploma in Science and Environmental Management. Eva Rose Moringa in Health Psychology and a postgraduate diploma in Science in Health Psychology. William Francis Parker in Physics. Stephen Mark Robinson in Speech Science. To the degree of Master of Science, Matthew Paul Gosling in Geology. Sarah Louise Graham in Forensic Science. And Wai Shun Lung in Biosecurity.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Clinical Psychology, Maya Ehrman. Maya critically explored parental experiences of raising a child with autism and the impact of autism on the family. Navjot Gill, University Doctoral Scholar. Navjot investigated the five-year neurophysiological outcomes, neuropsychological outcomes of subarachnoid hemorrhage and their relationship to disability, handicap, quality of life and mood with a view to determining how best to intervene to improve long-term outcomes. Yeah. Nicole Laura Jamieson. Nicole investigated daughters' relationships with non-residential fathers following parental separation, in particular daughters' experiences in these relationships during childhood, adolescence and adulthood. She examined aspects both within and external to the relationship as impacting on their closeness with fathers. Vicky Marie Mobley, University Doctoral Scholar. Vicky investigated adults' and children's perceptions and expectations of the step-parent and parent roles in step-families. She explored the idea of step-parent and parent roles in terms of the warmth, support, and discipline control dimensions of parenting and compared the views of adults with those of stepchildren. The research also examined the association between ideal step-parent role perceptions and satisfaction with relationships in the step-family. Helen Louise Vikerpohl. Helen investigated the cognitive and functional outcomes of five-year survivors of intracerebral hemorrhage as compared to matched healthy controls with a view to identifying targets for intervention. Sarah Watson. Sarah investigated the psychological impact of having long QT syndrome, an inherited cardiac condition, in order to contribute to the international literature and to help improve services in New Zealand. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Noor Ashikan Adam in Mathematics Education. Ashikan conducted a study into the mathematics of triaxial weaving in Malaysian food covers by being the intermediary in a dialogue between weavers and mathematicians. The results led to a new mathematical computer environment for displaying triple weave patterns and also to new weaving products that are now on the market in Malaysia. Asad Ali in Statistics. Asad developed and applied sophisticated simulation strategies to the detection and parameter estimation of EMRI signals in data from future space-based interferometric missions such as LISA. Glenn Philip Archibald in Chemistry, University Doctoral Scholar. Glenn developed methodology aimed at the flexible preparation of a small library of compounds of synthetic and therapeutic value, as well as a concise synthesis of the natural bioactive compounds, swainsonine and epiquinamide. Matthew Vincent Auger in Mathematics, University Doctoral Scholar, Bright Future Top Achiever Doctoral Scholar. Matthew investigated various means of determining the size and structure of finitely presented groups and developed a new method for finding their dihedral quotients in order to answer important questions about the fundamental groups of hyperbolic three manifolds. Matthew. Kerry Marie Borkin in Biological Sciences. Kerry investigated the ecology of the long-tailed bat in New Zealand plantation forest, and in particular the impact of clearfell harvest operations. This work resulted in a detailed understanding of how forest loss affects this endangered species and scientifically based management plans aimed at protecting them. Caroline Elizabeth Brown in Biological Sciences, University Doctoral Scholar. Caroline studied the occurrence and function of Acidivorax temperans, a bacterium found in the activated sludge wastewater treatment process. Her work supports the use of Acidivorax as a model organism for studies that underpin more effective wastewater treatment processes. Richard David Bunker in Biological Sciences, University Doctoral Scholar. Richard investigated the structure and function of three proteins that are suspected to be involved in some of the complications associated with diabetes. From their detailed atomic structures, he worked out how these proteins function, and in one case discovered a completely unexpected role in the formation of kidney stones. Hao-Han George Chang in Biological Sciences, University Doctoral Scholar. George investigated a well-known but poorly understood metabolic abnormality in diabetes mellitus. His research found that the urinary excretion of inositol sugars might serve as a clinical biomarker to measure kidney function. Peter J.N. Choi in Chemistry, University Doctoral Scholar. Peter carried out the synthesis of several natural products which exhibit potent biological activity and in particular anti-cancer activity. John Joseph Finnerty in Psychology, University Doctoral Scholar, Bright Future Top Achiever Doctoral Scholar. John's research looked into the threats posed to young people's well-being by the internet. It explored how they felt about and managed these threats and encouraged adult support as a critical tool in confronting these problems. Sarah Megan Flynn in Environmental Science. Sarah investigated rates and patterns of decay and nutrient release in mixtures of conifer and broadleaf leaf litter to provide further understanding of these mechanisms that allow the two forest components to coexist. Kerr Jing in Computer Science, University Doctoral Scholar. Kerr developed a novel method for transforming database queries based on the semantics of the data. Whereas most current query optimization methods are based on the structure of the data being queried, Kerr's method was based on the content or meaning of the data. He demonstrated that the performance of XML query execution can be improved by 20 to 30% using his method. Dong Jun Lee in Chemistry, University Doctoral Scholar, Bright Future Top Achiever Doctoral Scholar. Danny investigated the synthesis of immunologically relevant glycopeptides and also neoglycopeptide neoglycoprotein analogues using modern chemical ligation methods in click chemistry. Jamie William Booth Mackay in Biological Sciences. Jamie studied the population ecology, genetics and behaviour of house mice on islands with the aim of improving the success of mouse eradication attempts. Narissa Evelyn Merritt in Psychology, University Doctoral Scholar. Narissa investigated effects of normal ageing on the ability of individuals to perceive and shift attention in response to peripheral visual information. Findings from this project have provided valuable information regarding the cognitive and perceptual changes that accompany normal ageing. Sean Adrian Means in Mathematics. Sean theoretically tested an experimental hypothesis for how gastrointestinal cells generate steady rhythmic contractions. Dang Sum Nguyen in Chemistry. Dang examined how the wine technology of micro-oxygenation can help make better red quality wines for New Zealand winemakers. Unwanted rubbery aroma compounds were identified and approaches to remove them in the winery were demonstrated. Tao Chi in Biological Sciences. Tao investigated the structure-function relationships of the receptors for the calcitonin family of peptides with a view to contributing original knowledge to rational drug design. Christian Plaxton Serta in Geology. Christian investigated the diversity and paleobiogeography of fossil invertebrate communities living around hydrocarbon seeps on the seafloor millions of years ago, with the aim to contribute a better understanding of the evolution of life in extreme environments. Norsarama Saleh in Computer Science. Norsarama investigated how to improve the implementation of pair programming as a pedagogical tool in higher education. Through understanding the impact that the variation in the personality composition of paired students has on their academic performance. Jenny Ann Stanley in Marine Science. Jenny discovered that many species of coastal crabs use the differences in underwater sounds coming from different coastal habitats to decide where they are going to live. The results have the potential to be used for improving recruitment of crabs and lobsters to our coasts. Toby Vaudrey in Computer Science, University Doctoral Scholar. Toby contributed to the design of vision-based driver assistance systems in a collaborative project between the University of Auckland and Mercedes-Benz in Germany. He improved the robustness of implemented algorithms. Anne Roberta Wilcox in Statistics. Bobby created a unique database of performance data on elite netball players and applied statistical techniques to the analysis of these data. The insights developed from the analysis have informed the selection and strategy decisions of the Silver Ferns coaching staff, of which Bobby is a member. Zoe Elizabeth Wilson in Chemistry, University Doctoral Scholar. Zoe worked on the synthesis of the extremophile natural product bicalic acid, which exhibits potent activity against ovarian cancer. J. Ji Zhang in Biomedical Science, University Doctoral Scholar. Ji investigated the regulation of proteins that enable direct cell-to-cell communication and damage spread after spinal cord injury. She was able to improve spinal cord injury repair strategies with tissue or nanofiber implants by blocking the production of these proteins, resulting in improved behaviour outcomes. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the Book of Convocation qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma in the Faculty of Science.
On behalf of the university, I now invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. This would be the perfect opportunity for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they achieve their qualifications. This concludes this meeting of Council and Convocation of the University for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori and then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of your programmes.